On the bench for this episode, the highly anticipated, desired, and wanted Ford Mustang GT4 in 1/24 scale from Tamiya. This kit was sent over to me by Model Roundup the minute it came in. I will put a link down in the description where you can get this from Model Roundup, the best price for it on the interwebs. Let's take a look at all the plastic that's going to be inside. Now, I was very surprised when I looked up a couple reference picks. We know that I don't worry too much about being absolutely perfect, but I wanted to get this one close, that this thing, the plastic is molded in a lot of colors, and I won't have to actually paint the entire kit. A lot of this stuff I'm going to be able to just put right on the model. So I was super excited about that, and we're going to see how it turns out. Check out the detail on that racing wheel, that semi-oval shape it has. We got all this kind of slide molding. Look at that front grille. That is just amazing. All these inserts. I love this plastic. It's like that Tamiya vinyl plastic, which will help us out a lot getting that look. Look at the diffusers and the spoilers, the side diffusers. We got our air scoops, our vents all molded open. Amazing. We got our nice dashboard molded in that. See that texture to that plastic? It's supposed to be like that. That looks like the real thing in all the pictures I saw. Check out those wheels. Gorgeous. Brake discs. It is a curbside, so you will not have a full engine and transmission. You will have the hint of an engine and transmission from the bottom. The hood doesn't open. Again, that's a curbside style model. We've got our driveline and steering. Check that out. It snaps in. That beautiful exhaust system. All racing components. A lot different from the real Mustang, of course. Got our struts, our suspension, even got the tiny little hooks and clips. Oh man, teeny itty bitty little baby parts on there. We've got the interior tub. Guess what? Even on the gray Mustang back here, that's the way I want to do mine. It's white inside, and I didn't know that, but now I do. Went up, looked some pictures, the roll cage and everything is white, and this is a very opaque plastic. You can see moving my fingers around behind there with a lot of light in here. And you can't see through it, which means if you want to leave it white, you can just do it as is. Easy peasy and fun modeling. A lot of you guys don't want to have to put in a ton of work to make a model. I don't like to have to put in weeks of work, so I love these type. If you're doing the white edition, you don't even have to paint it. Look how glossy that plastic is. Look at that shine going across the fenders and everything. If you brushed a coat of Future over that, no one will be able to tell you it wasn't painted. And the ones that did, just push them down the stairs. Excellent molding on that body, ready for the front clip, all the way around the back, windows, antennas, areas for all the door handles, and the mirrors are prominent for the side trim, for the side marker lights. There's no hunting or ruining a body by gluing anything on sideways. Excellent. Let's go to the other side of the desk and see what else is there. We've got a large clear parts tree. We've got our headlights, our taillights, our windshield, our back glass, our side glass. This race car doesn't have open windows. It's got them all closed up. We've got our beautiful taillights there. Headlights. Excellent looking. Very tough looking machine. We've got our chrome parts to back up the lights. Large racing mirror. Marker lights. All the mirror glass on there, which is chromed out so it reflects. We've got some rubber parts in the box. Four matching tires. They're all the same size. I do not see any brand names on the tires themselves. They are slicks, of course. It is a race car. You get four of those. They're very sticky rubber. We got some poly caps to help the tires and the wheels slide on. And then we have a nice decal sheet for both versions. The white version 18, the gray version 17, and then our universal decals. We got some belts on there. All the Ford Performance logos. We're not done with decals and stickers, so don't even think we are. We've got another sheet of interior logos, exterior logos, small items on that waterslide decal sheet. We also have window masks. You got to paint all the black surrounds around the glass, so make sure you use your window masks. And one of the other cool things in the box, background information. Tamiya loves doing this. gray, white, where all the decals go, the color callouts, and anything you could want to build either version with some English text telling you the history of the car, and of course multiple languages because Tamiyas are popular all over the world. I'm going to get to gluing things together and I'll be right back. Except for some small parts, the painting scheme on this really isn't complicated, but I did decide to do some things to paint stuff up and then push them together later. Now, first off, we'll talk about the glass. I have those masking stickers applied on the inside of the glass for the Tamiya. On the outside, I always like to cover it so that I know I'm not going to get any overspray on the outside of the glass. If you're using an airbrush or another other detail painting, it's usually easier. I use a stronger spray can, so I always like to mask off the opposite side. You can see all those decals go in there. Lovely. All this will be painted a NATO black or an off black so that it looks like that tinted blacked out sections of the windows. I assembled the roll cage on its own. You can just place that in the interior tub. Get everything glued together. It fits in beautifully. Then we'll remove it. I am going to prime and paint that roll cage, even though it's in white, because I want it to stand out a little bit different than the all-white interior that I'm not going to be painting, except for some very small parts like fire extinguisher bottles and other systems that I will be hand painting. It's all white in the real car, and then I'll clear coat it, and we'll be all set with that, and that will be all ready to go up underneath. And I'm surprised that it was white, but that's what the reference picks say and that's what the manual says, so we're going that way. All these black parts here are pretty much press fit once we get the car together. We got our diffuser, we've got our air vents, we've got different kinds of air inlets and outlets, we got lights and all that stuff. All this will just be painted black with some flat black, and then we'll be able to go. I might give it a satin or something, bring a little detail to it. Same with the tail lights, the spoilers, the grill, the seat. I'm just going to be painting them with some black spray paint. I like the texture on there, so we'll just enhance it a little bit just by getting some color on it. Same with the interior door panels. Nothing fancy. Get those painted on there. So we're just going through the parts. I put the spoiler together so I didn't have to try to glue all these little pieces on after it was painted. They all requested to be black anyways, so that'll be easy enough to just grab one of the supports and get it painted. Anything that needs to be shaded or anything, we can always do with a hand brush and have fun later. Got the suspension apart, glued on its little part. Now we'll get this painted and detailed by hand before we attach it to the car. We've got our tow hooks. Those need to be painted red, so I cut those free from the tree, and we'll be able to paint those up, attach those to the car. The steering wheel and everything is staying black. It's got some decals. We'll be able to put those on. So I did assemble it, and now we're just setting it on the side so we have that assembly ready to go. The mirrors themselves need to be painted blue, the same blue or a close blue to the accent colors on the decals we looked at in the beginning. Those are on their own tree. We'll be able to paint those as well. Things go pretty easy. The door handles are body color, so I cut those free from the body tree so they can be set same as the front clip. And that mounts on there super, super nice. You can see there's no mold attachment points here all along the bottom. That is just going to, when we get to that point, whoop, we got large tabs on either side. There we go. And it should have a seam anyways with the real car. That will be nice. That goes on there real nice. We'll be able to paint that separately, along with painting the body, which needed no work on it whatsoever. We're just going to get it primed and painted. The chassis, the exhaust, I just left some of the trees on. We'll get that metallicized. It's already black, so I don't need to put a primer coat on that. We'll just get a metallic color over the top of it. The brakes need to be done in some metallic tones, and then we'll hand paint the calipers. The wheels need a gunmetal, and I do have Tamiya gunmetal, so I'll just match it up with that. Spray over the black. We'll get nice shadows immediately over the black plastic. We've got some suspension components here, some frame components, driveline. Those can all be left as is, detail painted, and then attached later. So we'll just leave them on the trees so I can paint them and hold them. We've got the under chassis all set to go. We've got these little radiators here. They want them black, so I was able to attach them. I'm not going to paint the bottom of the chassis. I rarely look at it on my cars. So if it's supposed to be white, we'll just go ahead and leave it white. The engine, on the other hand, and transmission are separate units. They want that all aluminum, which of course makes perfect sense in this car. So we'll get that painted. We'll be able to attach that in. And in the drive line, I will just give a coat of paint to bring it out and any little small detail painting. And then we'll paint the edges of the hubs like they want. Anything that we'll see when we turn it over. But otherwise, that's our chassis right there with some parts already glued on so that the glue would be dry when I start attaching other things. Super easy build. pay attention to those excellent Tamiya manuals. I'm gonna get over into the paint section and get some color, and then we'll be back. Thank you.
Thank you.
What I've been working on is getting the interior all set up, and that's ready to go. We've got our chassis here. It still blows my mind that that car is white underneath and inside, but that's just the color Ford went with, and it's their car. You can see how awesome the wheels look with those little Brembo decals on the caliper with the brakes behind it. Those things look really tough. In the gunmetal with the little titanium or gold-colored lug nuts. The interior is beautiful, stark and plain, but it's a race car, so it's not supposed to be super fancy inside. Nice details on there. I've got all the interior decals on it for the buttons and switches and the steering wheel, and just trying to follow the manual as close as I can be. This is not, of course, folks, don't look at this as the end-all, be-all build of the Mustang GT4. This is a two-day build for a full review, just so you can see how it goes together and how it can look when you're done with it. If you want to dedicate a full week to this thing, which you could really make this a show-stopping build, but that's not what I do on this show. I do quick, fast, efficient reviews so everyone can see what the kit goes together like and enjoy themselves and build it how they wish when they get done. I even love how the mirror attaches here to the roll cage. Check out that seat with the seatbelt decals on it. That's just awesome. That nice sparkle racing seat. Everything on there is just spectacular looking. The interior is ready to go. I've got a bunch of little parts ready to put onto the body. We've got diffusers and air dams and spoilers and grills and the rear inserts and the taillights and body trim on the bottom. And that all I wanted to do in a semi-gloss, so I painted it all flat black to begin with. And then when I future floor polish the entire car, glass over the decals and everything, when I brush it on, it will semi-gloss all that flat black for me easy, and that's a really easy technique that I do. We got the spoiler together. That's going to sit back here on that nice-looking Mustang shell. We got the glass glued into the body with a Mod Podge like I showed you. We had that glass taped off. So all I have to do is clean it with a wet Q-tip to get all my fingerprints off of it, and that's ready to go. And the body just needs a couple coats of future over the glossy finish to finish it off. We've got that red tow hooks on it, front and rear. We're pretty much just going to be pushing stuff together at this point as I switch to the other side of the desk. I got the taillights painted up. Got the black around the outside of the taillights like the manual says. We got our little silver accents I did with a silver paint marker on all the parts that we'll be slowly attaching to the car as we go. Got the mirrors painted. They want the bottom part of the mirrors black, so I hand painted that off camera. Then we'll be putting in our chrome mirror inserts on those with some more Mod Podge. The door handles we'll just glue right on in their little pin areas. These are our exhaust pipes and the mirror glass. The exhaust pipes are here, two-piece, and they will come out the back of this part right here on either side. So we've got some just cool stuff to bolt together. I've got to put the body together, get all the accessories on it, then I will put the body on top of the chassis and attach the wing. So when I get that all together and get the body on the chassis, before I have any decals, we'll take one last look at the car to see what it looks like naked. See you soon. All right, we're right there. Everything's been going together really nice. Back when I reviewed the Z car from Tamiya, one of the last Tamiya automobiles I had built, some of the headlights and stuff were a little fiddly. Tamiya has gone through and redesigned how they put things together and have really made it super nice. First, we'll talk about putting the decals on. That's the one of the last steps we have to do. I have cut free just the decals that I need. I'll be slicing those sheets and applying it using Tamiya's own Mark Fit to make sure that they fit down to all the complex and hard curves on the body. Use that manual for the correct color. Get in there, get them all down, let them dry up. We'll be all set to go. Excellent illustrations with the decal numbers. There's no guessing like some manufacturers can leave you to. We've got the mirrors together with the reflective glass. We got those painted. Those are blue. Those go in the body, and I tried to match that blue as close as I could to those decals. We got our wing, which is just going to position over the top. The parts that are left are a rear diffuser, the front diffuser are reversed, and this little tiny accessory, itty bitty part, goes in the hole on that roof, and I'm going to be gluing that on just before I do the decals, but I don't want to glue it on before I put the body on the chassis. They say to put the body on the chassis, I just have to spread the bottom of the body out and put it on, so we'll give it that shot. I have future floor polish the inside of the glass to get it crystal clear, I will then future floor polish the entire body twice, all the way over. I brush from front to back, back to front. I cover the entire vehicle, glass and all, with two coats of that, and that we will have our gloss once I'm done with the decals so it looks like a uniform surface. Check out that body. That is tough and tight. Those headlights are really mean looking in there. We got that front tow hook. We got all those individual spoilers are individual black pieces that Tamiya has cast. There's no intricate painting involved or anything. Just spray them black and put them in. That's it. Same with the vents. The windshield, of course, was masked. You can look underneath and see the Mod Podge and the super glue. And it's super wet around there because I just kind of slather on the future to seal all around the edges as well. The inside of the headlights, they want you to do white to bring out a little bit of those side marker lights. You can see them shining white through there. So that's what I did, and then we glued everything through from the back. Everything lines up. The tail lights are in. The tailpipes are in. Check out the tail end on that cutie. That's nice. We got a little tow hook back there. We got our exhausts. We got our I don't even know what those holes are. Fueling holes? I don't know. You guys tell me what they are. Fuels, I think. We got our tail lights in. And that's all flat black now, but this will all be semi-glossed when we do the future. It won't give it a full gloss. We've got all our black body trim in and around. All our side air dams. It just all just pops together really nice. And a little bit of super glue, just little dabs from the dollar store super glue gets it together. One last look at that chassis. Beautiful underneath. Yes, it is white in real life. Excellent. I'm really enjoying this. Sometimes these Tamiya kits can be so refined that they are a little fiddly with the super tiny parts, but this has worked out pretty well so far. If I can even do it on camera, you can see that the little wing mounts and everything just pop together like that. How often does a wing mount on the back of a car that lined up that easy and that nice? So I'm going to get the body over the chassis, get these final couple little parts on. We're going to decal it, come back, show you that final. Without any fuss, without any muss, the Tamiya Mustang GT4 is ready for your viewing pleasure. A two-day build, that's all it takes me for most of these. Even a more complicated kit like this with such finely refined details goes together like a pleasure. Tamiya has really gotten this down to a perfect art over the years. A couple kits ago, I had built that 370Z from Nissan, the Tamiya version, and the headlights were a little wonky, the taillights were a little difficult. Well, no more. They've really figured out how to put the lights in these things and get everything to just kind of push together with little tabs to run some glue on like I showed you underneath, and they go together beautifully. Everything aligned. Let's talk about alignment for a second. We'll pull it off. These diffusers are attached after the body is on. So if things weren't built right and weren't lined up right, these little seams would be giant gaps, and they're not. All the way around to the backside where they're perfect. I mean, we can see the underbody looks awesome. We're covering up most of that engine, but we can see the transmission and the exhaust going all the way back. The exhaust, if you can see it, even lines up with the tailpipes and looks correct. It's insane. The fit and finish on this thing is beautiful. The only really thing that gave me a little stress was masking that glass. I'm always afraid I'm going to get paint all over the glass. So I would like to see Tamiya start pad printing their glass like Ravel does and the other big companies to make our lives easier. But if they're going to keep including masks that good with tape that good, then really not. It is a non-issue. I did brush on two coats of future floor polish over the German gray. Model Roundup has the correct German gray. They have the gunmetal. They have the Tamiya sprays that will go on this car to give it the perfect color that Tamiya says it should have. And it looks absolutely outstanding. It looks just like the box art. The decals go on nicely. They take a while to settle down, but let them dry fully and settle down and you're going to be all set. So everything works out well. I mean, it's just everything is designed. You can paint it separately, attach it later, put it on, super glue it together, and you don't have to worry. And that white interior and white chassis is still going to kind of bug me. I know it's correct, so I left it that way, but I've never actually seen that in a race car. It's always some sort of a color or underneath or whatever. So that's really cool that it's different nowadays in the more modern vehicles. I love that you can see the roll cage and braces through that windshield and how positive the glass locks in, all the little mounting tabs for the vents on the hood, all that kind of stuff is just done beautifully. The tow hitches, paint those up separately and they just slide into place with a little drop of super glue. Everything is so nice on this kit, well designed. The wheels and tires will pull off. I showed you how nice those brakes look behind there. They are just outstanding. This is a very, it's one of my favorite models of 2020 so far. The crazy year that 2020 is, Tamiya releases this excellent kit. So I will put links in the description for the paint, for the car at Model Roundup. You guys can order it there. Remember, always build for you, build the gray version, build the white version, build your own Mustang GT4 race version. Use that body, get your own decal set. Find it online at Model Roundup, has a gajillion types of decals. Pick them up, make your own, and use the kit decals for the Ford logos and stuff if you want. Build for you and no one else and enjoy your kit. I built it like the box because I get a big kick out of that because it reminds me of being a kid and trying to make it look like the box, and that's what I do a lot of the time. Otherwise, I just want you to have fun and enjoy your hobby, and I will see all of you back at the next kit review.